ஷார்ட் ஹேண்ட் டிக்டேஷன் ஆகஸ்ட் 1985 80 வேர்ட்ஸ் பர் மினிட் 10 மினிட்ஸ் ஸ்பீட் 5 செகண்ட்ஸ் நவ் ரைட் ஐ வுட் லைக் டு வெல்கம் யூ டு திஸ் மீட்டிங் ஆஃப் தி சென்ட்ரல் அட்வைசரி கவுன்சில் ஆன் ட்ரேட். வி ஆர் மீட்டிங் எட் ஏ மோஸ்ட் அப்பர்ச்சூன் டைம் வென் வி ஆர் இன் தி மிடில் ஆஃப் அவர் ப்ரிப்பரேஷன்ஸ் ஃபார் தி நெக்ஸ்ட் இம்போர்ட் அண்ட் எக்ஸ்போர்ட் பாலிசி. எட் திஸ் ஸ்டேஜ் யுவர் சஜஸ்டியன்ஸ் அண்ட் ஐடியாஸ் வுட் பி மோஸ்ட் வெல்கம். We are all aware of the fact that recent developments in the world economy have reduced the availability of resources from other countries to finance the process of development. There is great reduction of foreign aid programs and the terms on which resources from outside the country are available have become difficult. Even other source of commercial loans has become costly. The choice that remains is to manage the balance of trade position not so much by curbing the growth in imports which would reduce investment and production. There can be little doubt that export earnings would have to finance larger proportion of our imports and hence the shortage in our balance of payments. It follows that the position of exports at the present stage in India cannot be more. There can also be little doubt that it would be desirable to save foreign exchange by increasing our domestic production whenever it is cheaper in terms of domestic resources used. Towards this object, it is necessary to follow the existing policy. The scheme of trade policies is an important one. There is, however, close relationship between the trade policies and other policies which determines the performance of the economy as a whole. It shall be the duty of the new government to come forward with a more liberal set of policies in the field of finance, trade and industry by closer understanding of the concerned departments. It goes without saying that any improvements in the foreign trade position cannot take place without the improvement in the all-round economic situation. We are aware that there is need for further improvement of trade policies at this stage of our economic development. So far as the economy is concerned, our attempts must be continuous. In the field of trade, it shall be our desire to bring about changes in procedures by giving due place it deserves. The benefits of the above changes would certainly help consumers in the form of cheaper and better products. For this purpose, it shall also be our desire to provide strong government following better economic policies. In our economy, it is necessary that trade and industry respond to this new policy in a very helpful manner. In view of these trends, we are sure to reach our export target fully. Before I conclude, let me say a few words about the foreign trade situation. In recent years, India's exports have been very good in so far as it has made the best out of difficult situation. There has been constant growth in India's exports. It needs to be mentioned that our export performance, which has been encouraging, is not good enough to meet the needs of the economy at this stage of our development. We have to work hard for increasing further our exports, in which the trade and industry will have to do a lot. I am very hopeful that the discussions of this council would provide a valuable contribution to our important task of framing trade policies and economic policies in a more effective manner. Dear sirs, in response to your advertisement for supply of cheap radio sets, we would like to introduce ourselves as the main agents in Andhra Pradesh for distribution of specially made cheap and best community radio sets, which are useful in rural areas. We would like to bring to your kind notice that we have fixed the cost of these sets at a very low price to suit the rural people with more benefits, and the performance of these new sets is very good. We assure the customers service after sales for 1 year at every center. We may also mention that we are in receipt of several letters from government and other commercial institutions appreciating our efforts to serve the poor with our new type of sets and requesting us to supply more and more sets as the demand is so much that the existing agents are not able to meet their requirements. We further inform you that we are in a position to extend liberal concessions if there is quick response on placing bulk orders. If you are agreeable to our terms and conditions, we shall give reasonable discount, which could be mutually decided. We therefore request you kindly to consider our offer favorably and let us know your decision in the matter at your earliest. We will appreciate your patronage in increasing our sales promotion, which helps the rural people, awaiting early and favorable orders. Yours truly.